Hello everybody, welcome to the algorithm course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the pigeonhole sort process. It involves mainly four steps. The first step is to find out the largest number in the unsorted list, and then I have to create buckets whose quantity is the same as the largest number in the unsorted list. And then I have to copy the numbers into the unsorted list to the buckets of the same index value. Finally, I have to print out the numbers stored in the buckets in the order of the indices. Now, let us see an example. Suppose I have to sort these 9 numbers. They are not in order for the time being. The first step is to find out the largest number out of these 9 numbers. How can I do that? I have to assign the first value to a variable called largest. And now, the largest variable is storing 2, which is the first number in the unsorted list. And then I go to check the second number in the unsorted list. I see that 2 is equal to 2. That means I don't have to assign the second number into the variable called largest. At this time, the largest variable still remains at 2. And then I try another number on the unsorted list, which is 1 now. Since 1 is smaller than 2, I don't have to assign that number to the largest variable. So the largest variable up to now is still 2. And then I check the fourth number, and I see that 2 is equal to 2. That means I don't really need to assign that number to the largest variable. So in this case, the largest variable remains at 2. Now I check 4, and I see that 4 is larger than 2. That means I can assign that number to the largest variable. So we see that the largest variable becomes 4 rather than 2 at the beginning. Now I check another number in the unsorted list, which is 2 now. Since 2 is smaller than 4, I don't have to do the assignment to the largest variable. So that variable remains at 4. Now, another number is 1. Should I need to assign that number to the largest variable? No, because 1 is smaller than 4. In this case, I just remain largest at 4. And now I check another number, which is 4, and 4 is equal to 4 in the largest variable. So I don't need to do the assignment, because that variable is already 4. This is the final number to check in the unsorted list, which is 4 again. 4 is equal to 4 in the largest variable, so I don't need to do the assignment. And I can see that the largest variable is 4 after traversing all the numbers in the unsorted list. And we have already reached the end of the list, so we can say that the largest value is 4 in the unsorted list. That means I have to create 4 buckets. And how can I use the buckets? I'm going to show you now. Now I have 4 buckets with indices 1, 2, 3, and 4. And now I'm going to put the numbers into the buckets of the corresponding index. How can I do that? Let me show you now. Now I'm going to put the first number in the unsorted list to index 2 bucket. So 2 is put into bucket 2. And the second number is also 2 in the unsorted list. That means I put the second 2 into index 2 bucket. The third number to put is 1. I put it to index 1. And it becomes the first element in index 1 bucket. Now I put another 2 into bucket with index 2. So for now, there are 3 2s in bucket 2. Now I'm going to put another value, which is 4, into index 4 bucket. And it is actually the first element in bucket 4. Now I put another value, which is 2, into bucket 2. Now we have 4 2s in bucket 2. And then I put 1 into bucket 1 again, so there are now 2 1s. And then I'm going to put another 4 into bucket 4, so now we have 2 4s. And now I'm going to put another 4 into bucket 4. We find that all numbers are already put into the buckets. That means I can go to another step of the pigeonhole sort. This step involves removing the numbers from the buckets in the index order. What does it mean by that? Let me show you now. Now I remove the first one from bucket 1. And then I remove the second one from bucket 1. Now we can see that bucket 1 is already cleared. Now I go to index 2 bucket, and I remove the first 2 from bucket 2, and now I remove the second 2 from bucket 2. I remove the third 2 from bucket 2, and I also remove the final 2 from bucket 2. So now bucket 2 is also cleared. How about bucket 3? Since we have nothing inside, actually we can say that bucket 3 is already cleared. Now I go to index 4, and I remove the first 4 from the bucket 4. Now I remove the second 4 from the bucket 4, and now I remove the final 4 from the bucket 4. Now bucket 4 is also cleared, and we can see that now all the numbers are in order. And of course all the buckets are cleared when I'm able to show all the numbers in ascending order. And at this time, we can say that the sorting is complete. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions at the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.